consuming soy increases breast cancer.
I've heard this one a lot.
A lot.
Ooh. Now, this one's more like a 50-50.
I'm going 50-50.
People are fence-sitting on that.
True, false, yeah. Consuming soy is good for you. That statement is false. So,
that's really good, because I'm going to a restaurant that has delicious edamame tonight.
Yes. So am I.
Yeah.
Okay, so here's the deal. I apologize. For 16 years as a breast surgeon, yeah. I thought, okay, soy has phytoestrogens, these isoflavones. If you look at the chemical structure, it looks almost exactly like the real deal estrogen. Huh. So I told all of my cancer patients, just spit that miso out of your mouth right now. Edamame for you.
Right.
Because I thought it would act like estrogen and feed and fuel breast cancer.
Wow.
80% of all breast cancer is fueled by estrogen. So I was like, say no to soy. Until I wrote my book.
Right.
Then I finally looked at all of the research, and particularly since 2009, there have been a number of studies about soy in human beings as opposed to little rats and mice, because we're not the same.
Not the same.
Not only is soy safe, it literally drops breast cancer rates by 60% for soy consumers. And if you already have breast cancer, if you already have breast cancer, it drops recurrence by 60% and death
amazing.
By 29%. So here's the deal with soy. I want it to always be non-GMO, plus or minus organic, but always non-GMO. And when you pick the soy milk, you want the first ingredient on the box to always be whole soybeans, not soy protein isolate.
Gotcha.
So we've got soy milk, tofu, tempeh, miso, edamame. They are all good for the breast.
Woo! Everyone here is going to get the most important book in the world to them. Yes, everybody's getting Dr. Funk's book, Breast, the Owner's Manual.